doing? Hey, good to see you.
Steve, have you have a seat? Let's visit a little bit. What do you say?
Don't let me forget the ring, right?
No, I'm not gonna let you forget the ring. No, no, no. That's really important. I'm surprised you don't have it on already, man. I don't know. Gosh. Hey, from St. Louis to Arkansas. It's not that far of a drive, but how'd you end up there?
Oh, wow. Well, one, they recruited me. There were some schools that I thought would recruit me and didn't, but I was very fortunate that University of Arkansas recruited me. My mom was born in the state of Arkansas, had a lot of relatives in the Little Rock area, and the school was a perfect distance from St. Louis. It was about a six-hour drive. It was close enough to where if I needed to get home, I could, but far enough away to where I couldn't just go home, you know, whenever I wanted to. Just say if I wanted to go get some of mom's cooking, I couldn't just go home and do that. So it was a perfect distance away, perfect environment for a university, nice sized city, but not too big. You can't get into too much stuff, but it was just a great experience overall.
It was, it is an honor for you. I'll be honest with you, it's an honor for all of us in the room to have Coach Ken Hatfield with you.
Absolutely. Today.
Coach Hatfield, I saw him earlier. Where is he?
There you go.
Stand up, Coach. There's Coach Ken Hatfield, one of the best in the business right
here. Yes, sir.
Tell us about playing for Coach Hatfield.
Oh, it was an honor. He had such great experience as a coach, and the staff that he put together was amazing. I remain in touch with a lot of those guys to this day. And I don't know if you know, but like when Coach Hatfield came to the University of Arkansas, it was after I had actually taken my recruiting visit. Who was the coach before Ken Hatfield? The great coach, him going to Minnesota. Everybody, Lou Holtz. Lou Holtz was the...
easy to forget.
Yeah, I don't know. I shouldn't have forgotten him. But he was the head coach at the time, and when I went on my recruiting visit, and he made a change and decided to go to Minnesota. Then Arkansas hired Coach Ken Hatfield, and one of my good friends, Bobby Joe Edmund, was there, and I didn't know what to do because I hadn't visited. I hadn't met with Coach Hatfield at the time. I met with Jesse Branch, who was my recruiter, but Bobby Joe just really reaffirmed that, hey, it may be even better now with Coach Hatfield and his staff, and it was exactly that. Now, one of the things I got to say that about my recruiting days, I feel like I was tricked a little bit because, you know, back in high school, I played quarterback. I thought I was a pretty good quarterback, but, you know, when you're young, you don't really realize that, you know, sometimes you think you're good, but you're not as good as you think you are. But I think the my recruiter, Jesse Branch, and then the folks at Arkansas, they saw that, hey, I was a quarterback. I threw some interceptions. Then I went and made the tackle. So they liked that part of me. They liked the tackle part, not so much the quarterback part. So they told me, yeah, come on. Yeah, you can play quarterback here. And after a few practices, Coach Hatfield called me to the office and said, hey, Steve, you know, if you play quarterback, you can play, but it's going to be a while before you play. Now, if you move to safety, you can travel with the team, and you know we still want to redshirt you, but you'll get that experience of being in the locker room. And I said, okay, Coach, yeah, that makes sense. And you know, but so I think right from the beginning they knew that I could hit it from my interceptions much more so than I could pass the football. So hey, Coach, thank you for that.
A great move, a Hall of Fame move, right?
Hey, did you play in four bowl games?
Five. Well, I didn't probably play in four, but
all 5 years you were there, but four you played it. Tell me how, does one of them stand out more than the other?
Well, the Cotton Bowl stood out for us because that was our ultimate goal in the Southwest Conference was to get to the Cotton Bowl. And unfortunately, we had a couple of our players who were doing some stuff that they shouldn't have done before the game, and they weren't able to play. And I think that you know, impacted us and, you know, caused us to not be as good as we should have been on game day. But just a wonderful experience. It was like really, if I can relate to the NFL, getting to the Super Bowl and then, you know, losing the Super Bowl, it was a pretty big deal to get there. I wish we could have won. I think we would have had our two other players that we would have had a much better shot at it.
When folks, Steve, ask you about the Southwest Conference and the memories that you have, what do you share with them? What do you say about it?
Well, I mean, it was a great conference, a lot of wonderful history. Now being the team that's not in Texas was a little bit difficult because, you know, all of our games, we had to go to Texas, and when the Texas teams had games, hey, they didn't stay in state and, you know, drive down. So we felt like we were kind of on the outside sometimes, but there were always a ton of great battles and great friendships, great relationships throughout the conference, and it was truly an honor to play in the Southwest Conference, and I think it was one of the toughest conferences to play in back in the day.
Speaking of toughest conferences and toughest games, if you Google Steve Atwater, one of the things that comes up is the 1990 Monday Night Football game against the Chiefs.
Yeah.
And there was a couple of plays involving one Christian Okoye.
Yeah.
That stand out. What was that like when you saw him coming running downhill at you?
Well, you know what? My coach, Charlie Waters, is here. Where are you at, Charlie?
There he is in the back.
There he is.
There he is.
Coach Charlie Waters, yes. Well, Charlie Waters, he was my defensive backs coach my rookie year, and I think a big reason why the Broncos drafted me in the first round. And, he always told, he kind of prepared me for making big hits by the way we practiced in that. And then Dennis Smith, who was another safety there, we were looking at film, and Dennis said, hey, man, nobody's really just gone in and hit him straight up. Everybody's going for his knees. We gotta hit him without going low. And, I was a young guy. Yeah, I was like, yeah, okay, whatever you say, Dennis. And then the opportunity opened up, and it just all came back to me, the stuff that Coach Waters had taught me and what Dennis said, and just ran in there. And, fortunately, it turned out that way. Now, it could have gone the other way.
Could have,
right?
Yes.
And I'm happy that it went the way that it did. Otherwise, people would be asking me, Steve, man, introduce myself to someone. Hey, I'm Steve Atwater. Like, oh, you're that guy, Chris Nicoya. He put his knee in your chest and ran you over. But fortunately, it didn't happen that way. And, I kind of feel for him because he kind of goes through that when someone says his name. They'll say, oh, man, you're the guy that Steve had. And so I'm always sensitive to that. He's a man. He's a great guy too. So he has great play. But I still like to keep the spirit of it good.
Speaking of good men, our latest inductee into the Southwest Conference Hall of Fame, Steve Atwater, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you all my family for coming out too. Love you guys. All my Arkansas people, Lutheran North. Love you guys. Thank you. TJ, Jeff Hall Jr., Cindy, thank you.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Our next inductee, ladies and gentlemen, ready for this? Trailblazer at Baylor University. That's the best way to put it, because he was the first African-American to receive an athletic scholarship at Baylor. If you would, welcome Tommy Bowman.